Hello friends, myself Kirti Chandral, Assistant Professor at Oriental College of Technology, Bhopal. Today in this session, we are going to see about methods of irrigation. In our last session, we saw about irrigation, its necessity, its advantages, and what is the requirement objective of irrigation. In this session, we are going to see how we can do irrigation with many methods in various locations and according to the site conditions. Here we are having various types of methods, that is surface irrigation, subsurface irrigation and sprinkler irrigation. These are subdivided. Surface irrigation can be divided into three parts, that is flooded irrigation, furrow irrigation and contour irrigation. Flood irrigation is majorly we use in India, that is wild flooding and controlled flooding. Wild flooding means when the water for the irrigation flows with no control. It flows very fast in the steeper area and it is hard, very difficult to control the flood. The water will flow as it wishes. That is wild irrigation. Next is controlled irrigation. Controlled irrigation means when we are allowing water to flow down and irrigate the land, but it is in a controlled way. There are various methods for doing this, that is free flooding, contour laterals, border strips, checks or levees, basin flooding and zigzag flooding. Let's see what are these irrigation types. First, we saw in the previous slide that is surface irrigation. In surface irrigation, we are having flood irrigation. Flood irrigation is subdivided into wild flooding and controlled flooding. But here we are going to see about controlled flooding. Water is allowed from the irrigation canals into the entire field and it slow spread all the land. When the water is free to move in the land and it is occupying entire area, that type of irrigation is called as flood irrigation. As we can see in the picture, there is a crop sown and the water is flooded in the entire field. That is flood irrigation. Next is border, or we can say strip irrigation, border irrigation. Here in the field, we make a border in the exterior layer and the water for the irrigation is flooded through the border and it reaches to the field till the corners and the centers. Border strip method involves irrigation of field by dividing it into strips separated by two parallel borders. The size of the strip ranges 30 to 300 meter in length and 3 to 15 meter in width. In this picture, we can see how this is being done. In the top of the first picture, we can see that is the main branch available for the canal. That is not canal, that is a main levees, we can say levees available for the irrigation, and then it is subdivided into three irrigation. The separation between that is 10 to 20 meters. Through these ditches, the water flows and it reaches the entire land. Next is furrow irrigation. In this furrow irrigation, in the picture, as we can see, one-third of the layer is taken for the irrigation and then on the both the sides we are having levees, that is water to flow. Water is applied in a small stream between the rows of the crops grown on ridges of furrow sides. This method of irrigation is generally used to irrigation row, crop and vegetables. Next is basin irrigation. In our day-to-day life, we mainly use basin irrigation when we are cropping something, some of the tree in our home. That time we use basin irrigation. What is this? Basin method is almost similar to check basin method, where only the basins around the plants are irrigated. This method is suitable for fruit crop. As for example, we are having a banana tree. In banana tree grows a very big. So what we do in the side of the banana tree, mango tree, banyan tree, any kind of tree it can be, we dig a little in a dia. We dig a land in a dia and every day morning or twice in the morning we pour the water. That In the picture, you can see there is a digged land in the nearby dia of the tree, and the water is being poured. That type of irrigation is called basin irrigation, which we usually use in our homes for any kind of trees. Next is subsurface irrigation. Subsurface means the previous methods, that is flooded method, border method, furrow method, basin method, these were surface irrigation. Surface means which we are doing on the top of the surface. Next method is subsurface irrigation. Subsurface irrigation means here we are not irrigating on the top of the surface. Here we are irrigating the crop from the bottom of the surface, that is subsurface. Water is applied below the ground surface by construction, trench, and installing underground perforated pipes, line, or tile lines. Next, another one is sprinkler irrigation. Sprinkler irrigation, nowadays majority in the croppings we use sprinkler irrigation because of its so many advantages. This irrigation refers to application of water to crop in form of spray from the above of the crop like rain. Here, with less amount of water, we can irrigate a large field without wasting the water. What are the advantages of sprinkler irrigation? It is being used nowadays very effectively because it requires less amount of water and it can irrigate a large amount. Here, water erosion will not occur, and the fertilizer which we want to provide, we can add in the water and fertilize the whole land. So these are few advantages, as we can see here, that is low water loss. Water loss will be less, that is efficiency up to 80% increased. Saving of fertilizers. Here we add the fertilizer in the water tank so that the fertilizer will be provided through the sprinkler system all over the field. Suitable for any topography. It is suitable for any kind of land. It can be steep, it can be slopy, it can be flat. No soil erosion. Means the soil, the productive soil, that is called fertile soil, will not erode, will not run off with the water, because when we are providing the flood irrigation, the top soil of the surface will run off with the flood. So the fertile soil we will lose the fertile soil. But in this sprinkler system, the water is according to the rain, with reference to the rain, it flows all over the field, but the soil will not run off. Better seed germination, free aeration to root zone. It is very free, the aeration, the water content will go till the root zone. Uniform application of water. What are disadvantages? As we can see, there are so many advantages, but there are few disadvantages. Those are high cost. It is very expensive because we have to prepare the mechanism first so that the water supply, first of all, we have to prepare the storage tank, the water supply, the motor from which the water will flow. So it increases the cost of sprinkler method. Poor application efficiency in windy weather and high temperature. If we are having heavy wind, then the sprinkler system will not be effective because it is just like a rain spray pattern. If there is heavy rain, heavy wind, the spray, the water drops will move with the rain, with the wind. It will not go where it has to be gone. High evaporation loss. When it is flowing in a spray method, then due to high temperature, the water may evaporate. Water should be free from debris, matlab waste material. Physical damage to crop by application of heavy intensity spray. If the spray intensity is too high, then that spray can damage the small crops which are growing. These are the advantages and disadvantages of sprinkler irrigation. Next, the same we are having drip irrigation in the subsurface irrigation. This is also used underground method. Drip irrigation is also called as micro irrigation. It refers to the application of water at a slow drop by drop. In this irrigation, we are providing the pipe system, underground pipe system, just at the bottom of the crop, and there is a knob which drops one drop by drop, drop by drop, the water will come out and it will irrigate the crop. Here in this picture, we can see we are having a mechanism irrigation prevention, and here we are having pulleys, pumps and all these mechanisms so that the system of piping, zigzag piping goes through. This piping, we are having some nozzles. That nozzle will give one drop by drop nozzle, very fine nozzle from where we can get drop by drop water outlet. And in the nozzle, above the nozzle only, the crop will be sown. And in the particular times, it will be given. So all the drops will come out and it will irrigate the crop. That is drip irrigation. What are the advantages of drip irrigation? Low water loss, and hence it saves the water. Here water loss will be less because we are giving drop by drop to the crop. Enhance plant growth and plant yield. Save labor and energy. We don't need labor here. We don't need farmers to put their energies here. It is all done mechanically. Controlled weed growth, no soil erosion, improves fertilizer application efficiency. Few disadvantages are also there. High skill in design, installation and subsequently operation. Means its installation cost is high. We need skilled labor for using that installation and operational. Clogging of some conduit and opening in emitters due to sand, clay particle, debris, chemical precipitation and organic growth. When it is going drop by drop due to some sand particles, clay particles or some other chemicals, it may clog. Not suitable for closely planted crops such as wheat and other cereal grains. When the plant is grown with a certain distance, there we can use this type of method because we are providing the nozzle at a certain distances, not very close to each other. That's why in the dense cropping, we cannot use this method. This method is used when the cropping is in a certain distance. This is the irrigation method of drip. What is the conclusion of this irrigation method? Here we saw two types of irrigation method, that is surface irrigation method and subsurface irrigation method. Irrigation is the important theme for crop production, so we have to select effective method for it and also should not select any costly method. Irrigation is very important according to the field, according to the terrain, according to the crop and the temperature, we have to select the effective method of irrigation so that the yield, the production of the crop should increase and it will be beneficial for both farmer and for urban people as well as for the country. Prosperity, it will increase. So we have to go for the effective method of irrigation, should not be very costly. So guys, I hope you would have understood what are the methods of irrigation in both surface irrigation and subsurface irrigation. What are the methods?